Hello there, Ray here, and today guys I will be showing you how you can get these floating banners as well as signs, and some cool tricks which allow you to actually convert colors of banners as well. And we'll be doing more testing to see if this can be applied to other things in the game of Minecraft, and we are here on the Protic creative server where we design a lot of things you see in Protic survival server. While designing these flying water sweepers, I noticed that there was ghost blocks being produced, and if I would try to stop the flying machine by placing a banner up against it so it wouldn't be able to pull, since these are tile entities and pistons are unable to actually push past them, I would sometimes accidentally miss the real flying machine and would end up placing it on some ghost blocks that were produced from it. And that would cause some very strange stuff to happen. So I called in a couple of the Protic members, Ed Example, who is good at making ghost blocks generators, as well as Sheen, who does a lot to do with different types of glitches. And Ed Example designed this ghost block generator for me, so we can kind of do some more testing with it. Just flick this lever and it will produce these ghost blocks. And if you try to right click them, you can place blocks exactly where the fake block is. It's just a ghost block client side. But if you click with something you can't place onto it, it'll just make them vanish. You can place a block in midair. So over here, I have two of the ghost block generators facing each other. If I would click on these are all ghost blocks. And then if I flick these levers, you see I'm just going to make more of them. That side I got magma block. And this side I have ice. And since the game thinks these blocks are really here for the player, not necessarily the server, some of the blocks keep their property, like the ice is kind of slippery. If I push forward, it keeps sliding me. Something like magma blocks, though, does not actually hurt me. I'm not wearing like Frostwalker boots or anything. This has to do with how the server decides on how it gives different block properties to the player. So something like ice is client side, and something like damage from magma block is server side. So the server is actually checking to see if there's really a magma block underneath me. It doesn't see it. And then by right clicking it, the server is actually like seeing if I can use something in my hand against the block. And that allows the client to synchronize with the server and recognizes that there's no block here and I can fall right through it. So those are some of the basics of ghost blocks. Now when it comes to using the banner on them, essentially what I was doing, I was trying to place a banner up onto the side of a block like this, and the block would just vanish. But if there was another ghost block underneath, what I could do is end up clicking on the top of it, and this would place the banner inside of the block. And notice how the banner thinks it's sitting on top of something when it's really not. Now this banner is really there. If I go ahead and remove this, you can see it's still floating. I can right click it and it doesn't vanish. Let's go ahead and re-log. Even when I log back in, notice how the banner is still there, but the ghost blocks have been removed because that updates the client and server. So you can easily make a floating banner in survival by doing this trick. Now these ghost block generators here are designed for 1.12, but Ed Example also designed some for later versions using stuff like light to create plague. And there's even other ones you could do in newer versions. So this is a pretty cool rare. I think we should try to obtain these on the Protic server before we update, just in case something changes between versions. And this can all be done in survival. So let me go ahead and generate some more ghost blocks. And then if I go into survival and I go ahead and click on the top of this, you can see it uses one banner and it places it there. Now the weird thing occurs when I go ahead and try to place another banner onto this one. So what do you think will happen when I try that? A couple things could happen. The banner could update, pop off. I could end up placing a banner onto this one without it updating, both banners being there. But what actually happens is when I place another green banner up against this green banner, one turns into a black banner and one drops just as a normal green banner. So I just converted a green banner over into a black banner, which is really crazy because this means that what we did here is actually a data converter, because in version 1.12, they use the system of labeling blocks that are similar, the exact same name, except they gave them different data values at the end. So something like wool is number 35, /0. That's a data value, that /0. The next color wool is also 35, but in it has a data value of 1. Where a green banner has a data value of 10, and a black banner has a data value of 0. So this actually resets the data value from 10 all the way back to 0, which is kind of like the default. You can do this with whichever color banner you want. So we can come in with, let's say, a white banner, which is 15. Place it in there. We click on it with any color, so it can be another white one, and one drops off as the original color and one drops off as a black version with this data value reverted back to 0. So we can pick this back up. They are real items. Most of the time when you make a banner, you'll make it out of white wool, and then you'll have to dye the wool, which is a pretty costly system because every wool takes one dye in order to change its color. And then you can use that to dye yourself like a black banner. But here you can turn around and just take a white banner, which was crafted up, and turn it into a black one without using any dye. After seeing this, I was wondering, is it possible to use some other item to do a very similar thing and change its data value? So besides banners, there is also signs in the game. And in 1.12, there's only one type of sign. Don't really matter. Let's go ahead and give it a try. If we click on the top of this, we get ourselves a sign. Oh, we can even write in it. Let's write subscribe. Okay, so we can hit escape to leave that GUI. Now we have a floating sign. That is pretty cool. So you can make floating signs with the base being completely attached to nothing. We should be able to also remove these other blocks. You can use like your empty hand to remove those blocks. So now we made ourselves a floating sign. So I wonder what happens when we go ahead and right-click another sign onto that. You can't right-click signs in this version. So let's go ahead and shift right-click. We dropped two signs on the ground. Let's go ahead and pick them up. And they seem to stack, so they seem to go back into a normal variation of the sign. But since we are testing in creative, we can actually make signs that have NBT tags. If you guys didn't know, you can go ahead and... So you can put text into the sign, and then you can leave it. And then if you're in creative mode, you can pick block it by doing control middle click. This will make a sign that has the exact same data in it. So whatever you put in it will always be there when you place it down. So this one, you can see it definitely says NBT tag beside it. And that's the normal sign, look a little bit different. So let's go ahead and try that. First we'll put down the NBT one, and then we'll go ahead and I guess we can place NBT against NBT and see what happens. Shift click it, and they both pop off. What will happen? Are they both be normal signs, or are they gonna be ones with NBT tag? So let's see, this one's a normal sign and this one's a normal time. So they both lost their information to do with NBT tags. What happens if you place down signs and then put down a banner? So let's put down a sign first and then we'll place down our banner. Ah, okay. So that converted the banner into a black banner. So it seems like the outside item that you place onto it is what converts it. It doesn't really matter what the inside is. So we can pretty much place any type of block here that when updated breaks off, and then it will convert whatever we place onto it into its default value. So I wonder if we can place like ladders up against this. If I click on like right here. No, it don't seem like I can. So ladders can normally go onto magma blocks, but don't seem to really work here. Well, they're there for a second. Let's try it in survival. Does it actually remove a block? Oh, it does. So I made a ghost item in my inventory. So if I drop this ladder, yeah. So I just dropped a ladder. Yeah, I'm still have a ladder in my inventory. So it almost looks like it got duplicated, but it's just because the item was missing visually from my inventory, but it's still there. So it looks like it's missing here. So now it looks like there's no ladders in my inventory, but if I click here, they're gonna appear up magically. We also have vines, which seem to do very similar thing, and lily pads, which you can place on top of ice in normal Minecraft, so I can place lily pads right there, but it looks like it updates in this case. I think what I want to do next is actually lower one of these machines down, so the ghost blocks will be too thick. So if I miss, like the first one doesn't get placed on, maybe I'll place it onto the second one. So this generator is one lower than this one. I'm gonna switch out the block that they makes ghost blocks out of to be something a little more solid so we can test some different properties. So now I place ghost blocks down pretty much pretty low. And then this machine will place ghost blocks on top of those. So it's gonna be like a too thick wall of ghost blocks. And even though they're not really there, they do prevent the player from like walking through them or, you know, anything else. So you essentially could make like a road or bridge where people could walk on top of. Only players that were here during the making of this will be able to see this bridge and use it, where people who come later on or come through like another portal won't be able to see this bridge. So now if I go ahead and place like a banner right here, it makes more sense. It looks like the banner is actually sitting on top of this piece over here. Of course, when I right click it, it does the exact same thing, converting it over into a black banner. So what happens if we have like a normal vine here and we place in like our fake vine underneath? So if we click straight forward, it should place it there, but it doesn't. So test the lily pad, I put down some more ice, and if I right click from above. I would thought it would place it onto that ice, but it seems like it doesn't really pay too much attention to the lower block. But what if I place up against the side of it? Oh, okay. It tries to place it there, but it seems like it can't. Very similar to like the ladders. So we kind of have two things we're testing to see if we can make any other types of floating blocks, which normally shouldn't be floating. And we can also test to see if we can find any other blocks that can change their data value when we update them like that. So in this version, we have like a sapling, and we also have different saplings, which are all underneath of the same name. So I got one of the other saplings. I put in some ghost block dirt. If I right click from above, oh, it looks like it tries to plant it, but it doesn't actually plant it. The client tries to, but the server doesn't allow it, I guess. So it must be a case where the server's kind of doing some checks, making sure we can't place saplings on top of ghost block dirt. And this check must not happen when it comes to stuff like banners. We can place banners on top of a ghost block. Also in this version, there is different types of red flowers. So this is called a red flower. This one's also red flower. These are all essentially red flowers with different data values. Let's go ahead and give those a try as well. Oh, it seems like the same thing happens. There's also different types of tall grass. I don't know what tall grass zero looks like. Maybe it's one of these flowers. I'll know that these are double plant, and zero for them is the sunflower. So there must be a block in the game which is tall grass zero that doesn't show up in the creative menu. So if we give the player tall grass, oh, tall grass zero is, oh, it's the old dead bush. So here's, there's actually two different types of dead bush at this version. There's the dead bush, and then there is shrub, which is tall grass zero. Very strange. Now, even though it says these are tall grass and tall fern, I believe in this version they're still small when you place them. Yeah. And then to get the big ones, you'd have to bone mill them. So maybe we don't want to work with those. We want to work with something that's a little bit different. Let's go for the tall plants. These double plants, that's a 0-1. Let's go for the other ones. We got the real tall grass, which is here. The tall one, we'll click above. Oh, wow. What the heck? So I went back to the default one. That is really strange. So default one was 0, which is the sunflower. I guess in this version, it just has a picture of a sunflower. I don't really have a stem at all. That is crazy. So it's a floating flower top. And if we look at it with F3, it says double plant, it's facing north, it's the upper part of it, and its variant is a sunflower. So can we actually place banners up against this thing? No. As soon as I click it, it just vanishes. That was pretty cool. That was with the tall grass. I just clicked onto this. What if I click onto the side? Does nothing. What if I click onto this bottom one? Ah, okay. Just puts in another one. I think I'll do the same for this one as well. Yeah, don't matter which type of tall plant you use, it just produces these flower heads. Now these might be ghost blocks themselves. Let's relog and see if they're still there. So I'm back and it seems like those were ghost blocks. The flowers are gone as well as our dirt. Just scrolling through your creative inventory is a great way to get ideas, especially when it comes to weird testing like this. Let's try beds. Now in this version, when it comes to placing beds, there needs to be two blocks underneath for it to be placed. If there's one missing, you can't place it down. So here's two blocks, but I don't seem to like that. What about if there's two blocks underneath and I click it from above? Nope. What if there's one real block over here and a fake one and I place a bed up against the side? Huh, no, still don't like it. We also have these skulls, which are more like the banners and signs because these things are also tile entities and they have the data values which can be changed. If you guys haven't seen it, we made a skull conversion farm where you could convert wither skeleton skulls into skeleton skulls in this version. If you're curious about how that works, I'll link it down below. Let's try a zombie head. Place it on here. Oh, you can place it on there. Really? Wow. So, can I place another zombie head up against it? No. But essentially, I placed a zombie head onto the top of the block. I placed it onto the bottom of it. What if there was a block there? If I click here? Oh, I see. If I click on the side, it places it like I placed it onto the side of a block. Now, floating skulls aren't anything unique. You can place it onto a supporting block and remove it. But it seems what we need to do is make like a floating banner and then place a skull up against it in such a way that the banner breaks off and the skull breaks off. But the skulls don't immediately break off when you update them this way. Like if I place a skull up against this, it breaks the banner off, but the skull stays there. So it doesn't convert the skull. Maybe we could use like pistons or something to update both the banner as well as the skull at the same time. Because skulls can be pushed off using like a piston. So place a banner right here. Then if we push this piston, it should also update the banner at the back. Okay, they both popped off, but it didn't convert the skull. Let's try flower pots. In this version, you have to have a supporting block on flower pots. If I click here, okay, it seems like it doesn't like it, and it just breaks off. If you don't click directly onto the block, it seems like you can keep trying to place them. So if I was in survival, I keep placing here and using up all my flower pots. At least it appears that way. Oh, this is strange. So we have our skull here, and we're pushing ghost blocks into it, and it actually allows them to get pushed there. When normally, if you had something like even a ghost sign or even a floating sign, you normally can't push ghost blocks into it. So there's actually skulls behind these. And, can I click on them? What? Did I just convert it? Or is that just visual? What? I don't know. I also rotated this one somehow by placing in a banner. Okay, let's relog. That might just be a visual thing. It says it's a normal skull. If you look at F3, log back in. Ah, okay. So it was just a visual glitch. That was pretty crazy. We actually could visually change these skulls over into the default one, which is skeleton. We were also able to convert this one, make it turn the opposite direction. Crazy. Oh, that was just by pushing ghost blocks into them. And then I think I could just update it by right-clicking. Yeah, just by right-clicking. So if I go into survival and break this, I'm probably going to drop the right item. Yep, just drops a normal zombie skull. Weird. That was pretty strange. Do we have anything else we can use? Stuff like item frames and paintings or entities. They really don't apply the same way. I wonder if we stuck like some leaves in front of this. Did I try to push the leaves? Oh, I guess it did. Oh, interesting. So if I right click this, it brings the leaf back, but it changes its value, right? So this leaves are dark oak? No, it still says it's dark oak. Even though dark oak are data value 1 and the 0 value is acacia, still looks like it kept that value. So I think we tested everything kind of in this tab. I guess we could try to put some these monster eggs into the generator and see what happens. Because I mean, these are blocks, but they essentially have silverfish in them. So there they are. Go into survival. We should be able to break these at the same speed. Of course, they don't produce silverfish because they're just fake. All these components need to be placed on top of something. So place them here. Seems like they do the same type of updates where they don't like being placed there. You could also make like ghost block TNT, but it wouldn't actually ignite. Let's try something like doors. It seemed like stuff when it was too high kind of came out with weird outcomes. If I click here. Ah, nice. Let's see, can I open this or does it update? Ah, so it must be a ghost block. That's interesting. So anything that kind of produced too high blocks kind of forgets about the second top half. I wish I could do cactus, but they need a ghost block sand, which this thing can't do. Beds are 2 blocks, but they don't really work on this. So in this version, you need cakes to be supported by block, otherwise they pop off. So let's try cake. Nope. And we can't really place like signs or banners up against these since they just update. So what if we place different color like concrete? Because we can make different concrete color converters in this version. So we have like yellow. If we just click up against this. No, I don't change its color. So some of these tricks could still be used in future versions like the floating banner trick or floating sign trick. But when it comes to actually converting the data of the different blocks, you can't do that in the future versions because they gave all the blocks individual names instead of them kind of sharing the same name. If you guys are looking for a ghost block generator, it still works in the newer versions. Byron Uriel made a next video, which I'll link below, showing different types of generators that still work. had a lot of fun testing out all these weird things and seeing what could all be done with this. If you guys have any more suggestions of things I should test with this, let me know down in the comments. I hope you guys enjoy this more experimental video, and I hope to kind of implement some of the stuff onto the Protic SMP server before we update. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.